Hello everybody and welcome to Euro Truck Simulator 2. This is Jack Wall Let's Play. We've downloaded some files which I want to share with you. I have some mods to activate. We have the Pro Mods added in. This is the map that is Scandinavia, and I think some changes to the base map from SES as well. I've also downloaded the 4 files for the TSM map, but I'm not going to engage them because they would conflict with Pro Mods. But I am going to attempt to enable trailer pack 1, 2, and 3 from TSM, and the container pack as well, and see if that's going to work. I'm going to leave the hard economy off for a little while. We'll apply those and we will jump in and see if all is well. So the Pro Mods is coming in. You can see that they have the banner there. We should be in Vienna if all is going normal, and we are, because we would have been thrown back, and I think I did that offline. So we can jump in and see if everything is normal here and things are looking fairly okay. This is our base. Let me just get sorted out here with my okay, let's square that up. For some reason we're getting, oh, I know why. Ain't that thing. So let's get ourselves organized here. Fuel wise, we'll go and we'll get a little bit of fuel. Why not? We're at our garage, of course, so see if we can get a little bit of fuel for a cheaper price. And we're getting it for 114 a gallon, which is not bad. I don't need that much, actually. Maybe 20% of the tank to fill it. It'll still be a nice 300 or 400 euro, though. 363. Okay, so that'll get us around here, which is not too bad, and we'll be bobtailing it, I suppose, once we get out of there. Yes, sorry, Bob. So the next thing to do is look at the job market and see what freight we have and see how these interesting trucks and lorries being picked up. So we're in Vienna, and that is from Vienna to, oh, this is ice cream that I've somehow managed to pick up. Well, let's see what else is here. We've got tractors and lorries and tanks and more tractors and lumber and diggers and bigger diggers and more tanks and toys. We've got an IKEA truck. Okay, so interesting stuff, I suppose. I think a few items here are new. Those two lorries that we're dragging behind us, those tractor units, are different. I don't know if we've picked up some of the big items that I expected. I was expecting to see kind of helicopters and things in here. Let's scroll down to the other end and see if it's all just stuff like that. And it seems to be a car transporter there. Tanks, trailers. Yeah. So maybe those TSM trailer units only work with the TSM map. They would have worked anyway, though. Okay. So, click Vienna here again, and we do have Vienna to Norway, to Geilo, which is up here, as about as north as we can go in Norway. It's not far quite as far west as we can go, but it's not bad. It's 14 tons of ice cream. So let's do that. Off with us. Lights are not going to make the lights. Okay, so it looks like... Well, we'll see. Maybe we will see some AI with some trailer. But I don't think those big trailers were picked up somehow. I'm not convinced. We can do 7,302 kilometers bobtailing here with this 1,300 liter tank. Nearly 1,400 liter. It's incredible, isn't it? Green light means go, and I do have a go, so I'll throw an indication on here and tighten up my turn. Jesus, that's a bit aggressive. And we're in here straight away. Go a little further. Ka-kling. Alright, Gabna. Oh, there it is. We will take that. That will bring us up the Pro Mods route. And there's the trailer right beside us, so... All that is good. Get in nice and square. And does that click on? It does, but we're no way in right. We're no way near it. Magically, the trailer gets pulled forward. We do need to pop out and make sure the lights are working, and they are. And that's the truck. Right there. She's fairly close behind, isn't she? In fact, is she... She's not, she's inside it. But she's... Wow. She's coming around. That's probably not good for the trailer wheels, but there's not a lot of space there. But there is enough. As we bring her around. Alrighty then, turn off those flashers. Stick on, no, we're not going to make it out in front of those boys, are we? Right, Governor? Alright, Mr. Redbus? Kind of a shortened Redbus, isn't it? There's a nice Volvo pulling a container trailer. Haven't seen that container trailer before, that's new. Might get a little further down the road and pull in here. Make a save, go out of the game, disengage the TSM trailer packs, and carry on and see what the problem. I think that was a mistake to turn on the mods from the trailer packs, because I don't have any idea what's actually added in as a result of the Pro mods, because they might have added in trailer packs as well. I don't know, maybe that was a bad idea, was it? It'll be interesting to see what additions... because I understand that there's additions to the map. There's an IKEA sign, I don't recall that from before, and I can tell there's a big IKEA up here. And we're going around by it. I don't recall that IKEA being here in the old map. Outside of Vienna. Throw on the brakes there, Jennifer. I think that's the first new thing. It is too. Jeez, look at that. That's a green light coming on. Huh. Wow. How about that? That's nice. And it's really IKEA as well, so that's definitely not in the default map, no doubt about it. This is something that's new. And there'll be a delivery there as well, I'm sure. So we'll get to see what they've done. Ah, okay. That'll come. We'll do a delivery to IKEA soon enough, no doubt. Until then, we'll rock and roll. But, okay, that's the first new thing that we've noticed. I have no idea what the full list is. I kind of scan read the forum and, you know, generally looked around without terribly detailed effort. And I think somewhere I picked up that they've made additions to the main map, and well, there's the proof already. We've just passed that IKEA edition, which is certainly new. I wonder, have they made any additions to junctions and various things like that? I'm not really convinced that they would have, because I think that would be quite an undertaking within the code. But they might. I think there's a bigger difference and a bigger implication to changing the road than there would be to adding a prefab like IKEA, because the only things that would go into there would be the driver yourself. The scripting for the AI wouldn't be affected by that. Whereas I'm guessing that if you were to change the structure of a junction, you know, these motorways, these two-lane motorways where this lane bleeds off all the time and I'm constantly in the wrong lane, that kind of thing. I think that might affect AI quite a bit. Although maybe it is possible to, you know, reprogram the AI on that junction in some kind of a master file. And then it just does it everywhere. I don't know. I really don't know enough about it. I'm just assuming certain things that are maybe a little unqualified to even assume. But anyway. Anywho. There we go. We've just broken 80,000. I can't really blow the horn now to celebrate, because this guy is going to be thinking, what the hell, dude? But, I'll let him kind of get a little further away, and we'll try and celebrate before he gets too far. Oh, come on. He's not really moving far away from me. Let him get a little further down the road. Car passing me now because I'm going so slow. Yeah, I can pass him now, so. Celebration! So that was my Morse code for Yippee Yahoo Scooby Doo Yoo-hoo Woo! Or maybe it wasn't. But we've just broken 80,000 kilometers on the truck, and we're already less than 20,000 to go. So that's like pretty damn funky awesome, isn't it? I think it is anyway. We're making progress towards our goal of 100, and I mean, it's a pretty small goal compared to some of the people out there who've done much, much more. Million. 500,000. 600,000. That's, you know, makes my little 80,000 pretty paltry when you compare to somebody who's done nearly 10 times that. That's a lot of driving, 10 times that. But anyway, that's what it is. It's cool. We're doing our own thing. And, it's pretty cool. There's another one of those container trailers. And I'm just wondering if that's the container for... Yeah, I'm wondering about that now. Now, we are coming into Brno, and it says it's an 80 there. We're well under 80, so we should be alright. Traffic lights coming up ahead. We'll stay in this lane. There's another thing that's an addition now. Didn't get stuck with that. It's still an 80, so we're rolling through. It's kind of a bit late on those lights, but I won't be able to drive through the next ones. There's a couple of tractor units that are being pulled here, so what are they? They're Scanias. Two Scanias that are put up. Interesting how they got them up there like that. Looks like it's been pulled by, what's that, a Renault? No, it's a Volvo that's pulling it. I can't tell my trucks from the side panel yet. So yeah, that's interesting. Now, is that from ProMods, or is that because I enabled four files from TSM? I don't believe it's TSM, because I think I would expect to see other files if it were. Where are we? We're here. I want to go straight here. I know this is not our route. I need to temporarily go up here because, yeah. I remember making a mental note of this a long time ago, that I wanted to go up here. I think that there's a recruitment agency or something up here that I want to check out. I have been up in this area before, and I just want to go and see if I've got everything. Maybe I have already got everything. I thought there was a recruitment agency up there, but maybe I'm wrong. There's a hotel there. There's a garage up here that I want to go to. You know what we'll do? We'll go to the garage, we'll park up there, and then I'll disable the TSM stuff. And, you know, the big trailer options from then, and then I'll see what the ProMods actually has loaded in itself. So we'll go in here, we'll park up somewhere, and we will save up, and we will take it from there. They won't mind if I park in front of the main door, will they? I don't think they'll mind if I park in front of the main door. It won't be for very long. Alright, we're just going to drop the trailer there. And then I'm going to run over here and park up beside this this Renault. Just for the hell of it. And then, once we get ourselves parked up and saved, we're going to pop out. Turn off that, turn off the lights, everything is off. So we're going to escape out of there. We are going to go to save. We're going to save the game as... we're going to save the game as latest. Save, yes, I want to overwrite that. Bueno. Now, I want to go to Profiles, Profiles, and I'm going to go to Edit, and I'm going to disengage or disable these Schwerlast Trailer Pack 1, 2, 3, 4. And, so that means that we just have the three ProMods files, including our skin and including the real logo mod enabled, and that's all we have. We don't even have the navigator from Scania enabled. So we're going to apply that, and then we're going to go and continue. It should come up with a complaint, maybe. And we are going to go and collect that autosave. I think that autosave is going to be good. Four of those, yeah, the game might become broken. We're going to chance it. I hope it won't. It shouldn't. Although we'll find out now. Live on the stream. The game change was detected. Due to the changes, your deliveries were cancelled with no penalty and your truck has been reparked back in Vienna. Bugger, I think, is the word. Okay. Well, darn it anyway, but that's not the end of the world. We are going to go into Vienna, and we're going to do that drive again. Funny, we're not doing the same drive. We are now going to be taking to Portsmouth, but I don't go to Portsmouth. Helsinki, Finland. That's going to be interesting. Cars to Helsinki. No, hang on. What's going on? Helsinki yogurt, 18 tons of yogurt to Helsinki. There's an IKEA, 10 tons to Helsinki, doesn't pay as much, so we will go with that. Although if we go to IKEA, then we get to see IKEA. Okay, we'll do the IKEA. Interesting, there are much less in terms of loads. There's only three of them now. There were a hell of a lot more loads. Weren't there? Okay, so something was working with those load packs, those trailer packs. Okay. That's interesting. So what we're going to do is we're going to go back and put in the three ones again. Because they might be working, everything might be fine actually. I'm going to apply those four. Then we're going to go in and we're going to continue. And we're going to continue. And is it just going to automatically pick up from where we left off? No, it's not. We might have to try a load. So we're going to load the game from there. That looks right. So that was the latest. So we're going to load that and see if this works. And it does. Okay. Okay. No major damage done there. It was a bit of a kind of a risky play, I think, though. It doesn't always work out quite well when you do that. But what we will do is we'll run over here one more time and we will park and we will exit the game. There we go. We will exit the game and we will do a proper exit and save, and then I'll come back in a second. Alright everybody, hello again. We are back. We're back in the game and we're going back to our last save, and everything's worked out fine, so that's good. I'm happy about that. And we did a kind of a formal save within the game normally, so I'll be able to go and connect up here now, and everything is going to be dickery hum tuckety doody. There we go. So let's load up there. Jesus, it does move forward quite a bit, doesn't it? So we should be okay turning here. And we'll drive around these roads the long way now, just so that we register the road when we can. It's just taking advantage of things. Just one half a dozen of the other, so we might as well. So it does seem that some of those trailer packs are associated with the TSM trailer packs. Certainly those Scania tractors that were pulled by that Volvo truck were from that TSM, and there did seem to be a significant number of other trailers and loads to pull from. Just the volume of loads was much higher, so that was interesting. The IKEA ones were added in though by ProMods. Pretty sure about that. But I didn't have the option to pull the tractors, the Scania tractors, with just the ProMod one. So that the Scania tractors load is definitely associated with the TSM mod, trailer pack mod. So that's kind of interesting. So it is. There we go. It's a pretty quiet road up here because we're kind of up at the end of, I don't know, so it doesn't get any more complicated. We're not going to get out past this at this rate, lads. We need to drive out there now. Now this hopefully is going to stay for us, but no it's not. We're going to have to stop and wait. Dang nammit. Well, we have to go to the left here because the rest of that road leads to Oblivion. And we won't be able to pass. Only the special AI are able to go through that. As if by magic. They drive around into and then disappear. Green, we are good to go. Rules are clear. Right, well, we're back on route again. We need to drive down a little bit here and then pick up a right-hand feeder onto the motorway, as you can see on the GPS. Alrighty then, my lights on, they are now. calm, having a few lights. So we're on the way to Helsinki in Finland, and it looks like we're going to have a nice drive. We've got a little bit of a long trip. We'll go and look at some numbers now in a minute once I get this established out here. The distance to travel is 1,662 kilometers. Well, it's not that far then. I mean, it's quite a ways, but I was thinking it was... Really? I thought it would have been more. Although we are cutting across a lot of water, I suppose. We have 4 hours of driving left in this particular session, which at 12 o'clock, it's 4.5, isn't it? No, it's only 4. So that's going to get us out to around about 4:30. So about 4 o'clock, we need to be coming up on some place to stay. Here's the junctions that I'm talking about again. So they obviously haven't changed any of those. Or at least they haven't changed that one. I don't think they've changed any of them. No changes at all. Pity. Keep an eye on things, I suppose. The road map, the road signs will tell us. Yeah, but it's good. It's good. It's good. Snot. Sniz. So we're heading... Where are we going? We're heading north up through the Czech Republic now, I suppose. We have a few little hills to pull up, but we're not that heavy, so... What are we pulling again? We're pulling ice cream. We're pulling 14 tons of ice cream to Galio. Oh, actually, we're not going to Finland. Sorry, that was us messing around, wasn't it? We went back to the original job, so we're on the way up to Norway. That's why the number is only 1,600 and odd kilometers. That makes good sense. Surely it would have been longer if we were going to Helsinki. It looks longer anyway. But we're not going to Helsinki, are we? No. Going to Norway is cool. I've never been to Norway in the real world. I've been to Sweden. Haven't been to Finland. Haven't really been to Denmark either, I don't think. Flew into Sweden though. Went to Stockholm. And then went north up somewhere into the middle of the country to go camping for a week, basically. Well, kind of camping anyway. Which was kind of cool. You have people out at 3 o'clock in the morning walking around in this kind of dull daylight. Which, you know, it never really got dark. That's kind of weird. Probably not too weird for somebody if you're living there, I suppose. But I suppose it's better than the darkness. And you get those couple of weeks of 24 hours of darkness. That's, you know, or maybe just a little bit of light that isn't enough really to lift the darkness up, but it makes things just not quite as dark. It doesn't last for very long, a couple of hours and whenever it is, middle of the day, and then you're back to jet black again. That's kind of different. I think it has some challenges in some communities where people basically lose out on sunlight and vitamin D deficiencies and all that kind of stuff, I suppose. There's fewer people the further you go up the country, for obvious reasons. Still a nice place, Sweden, like it a lot. Nice people. Stockholm's quite cool. I went up with my wife for a couple of days, a bit of a long weekend, and then she flew off on her own some. She went back home, I went camping with some friends for a little while. Oh, stay in lane, Jack, geez. I can keep going past this fuel station. Do a little bit more, make a little bit more up the road. And then flew back with boys after that. So that was kind of cool. And I've had a little long weekend with my wife. Went out for some dinner and doing the sights and spending a little bit of time around Stockholm. The weather was fantastic. There wasn't a drop of rain. It was clear blue skies and a light wind. It was actually quite warm. It turned out to be an exceptionally warm summer. Temperature well into the mid-20s and actually where we were when we were out camping during the daytime it got into the very high 20s, touching 30. Practically every day. Well, it was 4 days, it wasn't a whole 4 days in the middle of a week, basically, so. And we took an extra day just to chillax as well. And yeah, it was pretty awesome, really. Great country. We actually went for a swim in the North Sea. So we were up on a coastal area. And that was cold. That was bitter cold. But for the first couple of seconds, it was confirming our brilliant idea to, you know, just refresh and kind of just get into the water and have a swim, and it would be so refreshing. But after about 6 seconds, I began to get the sensation that, man, this is actually very, very cold. Very, very cold. And after another couple of minutes, some of the guys were kind of swimming to the side. They were getting out. As far as they were concerned, they had enough. I was okay for a little while longer. I stayed in for a little bit longer. It was time to get out fairly soon afterwards as well for me. But you know, that was good. That was very good. What's that, Renault? Must have found this already. Yeah, I have, because some of the roads are orange, so I've been up around here. That's okay. Going straight over this roundabout and then following the road around. Oh, there is a question mark up here, though. Where is that? It's got to be down there somewhere. Am I going to be able to get to it? Maybe I am. There's a junction up here. That's the opposite direction, but I might go and pick up this question mark. Which will have to be a recruiting agency. But I'll do that. And then we'll have another recruiting agency to pick up drivers from, because our garage is max capacity now, although I'll step out and start the next one. So we need to hire one more person to replace me to bring it up to max capacity when I do start the second one. What is this car waiting for? No, you stay where you are now, because I'm not finished going around the roundabout yet. Where the fucking hell did that come from? Excuse my French. But I really hate that. Seriously! Maybe I wasn't indicating enough. And I'm getting blown at. What the hell? Yeah, whatever. Damn blasted anyway. Well, that's not worked out to be very well. Have I done any damage to my... No, I haven't. I haven't done any damage to my trailer. It's almost as if that damn thing has been worth it now. I'm gonna do something ridiculous here now and probably get in trouble for it as well, but... Maybe I wasn't indicating. Maybe that was the reason. I was trying to be careful going around there too. Just drove up under me, and this guy is just stopping here. I mean, what the hell is that for? I was coming around in that lane. Maybe, yeah, okay. Oops. Start indicating plenty of time early now. There's two lanes here though, so I can follow off the two lanes. There was only one lane in the other one, which did kind of confuse me because I was heading over into the leftmost lane as well. I'm thinking I'm giving the game far too much credit here. Not trying to give the game credit by way of alleviating my own responsibility, just accepting that I'm going wrong. I'm gone wrong. It's all going pear-shaped now. You're going the right direction, Bob. That's good. And I will just drive here like a maniac. Get into the right direction. So we get to go around the roundabout again. So, what did I score there? Or what did I... That was about 1,200 in damage because I collided with the car three times. Brilliant. Brilliant. As I may have said previously, I'm kind of got this sneaky suspicion. No qualification behind this statement, I just got this sneaky suspicion that if I drive poorly, my AI drivers start performing less. See, I'm indicating early enough now and nobody is there, but I'm going to stay in the second lane as I go off here and then work my way across anyway, but there's nobody there this time. I've got this sneaky suspicion that my drivers, their performance reduces. If my performance is good, solid, then their performance improves. And a sustained good performance on my behalf, meaning no speeding tickets, no crashes, probably not being late for deliveries, whatever else, not going through lights, all that kind of stuff. That's me maintaining good performance. That encourages my other drivers to not necessarily have bad performance, right? That's the logic. We're going to pull in here and park because I know it's 1:44, it's a little bit of extra time, but we're going to pull in here and park anyway. Give ourselves a break. And go down here to hopefully truck parking on this side. Yeah. We'll run up to these park benches up here. And bring her to a nice gentle holdy on the stop. Okay, handbrake on. Indicator off, lights off, engine off. And that has us parked for a bit of a sleep and catch you in the next leg, where hopefully, well, there's no damage showing up, of course, but there would be damage down here on the side of the trailer, surely. Maybe not a lot, but noticeable enough. That's the end of this video anyway for now, folks. As the man says, go handy, and until the next time.